Welcome back, my friends, to Let's Play Langrisser 2. Let's do what we do. On into Scenario 10, Defenders of Ral River. After learning the true horrors of Alhazard from the High Priest of Astol, and being told that the Dark Rod would be required to restore Alhazard completely, Elwyn chose to seek out the Dark Rod. If he obtained it first, the Empire would not be able to revive Alhazard. Elwyn and his party rushed to the Ral River to meet a wizard who was said to know the location of the Dark Rod. But when they got there, they were stopped by Lester, the guardian of the river. He's the one in the center there on top of the crocodile. Remind you of anybody? Anyway, we have to defeat him. That's the winning condition. If Elwyn falls, you know the drill. Now, we can actually buy some decent items finally. Necklace, very useful. It increases your unit's defense and their combat bonus. That is the bonus they receive from their commander. If I can say that straight. The ever useful speed boots. Hane's really not going to need them in this fight. They're going to make use of the water to take the advantage. We're going to be stuck on land, I think. Because the last thing you want to do is go out to sea to engage a sea unit. Makes sense, right? They're still getting that plus 50%, plus 30% terrain advantage, depending on if you're fighting them from the shoreline or in the water. So we're going to try to draw them towards us. Amulet greatly reduces magic damage. Don't really need that in this fight. They're not known for their spell affinities. All the same, I want to give Elwyn something. So let's check on everybody else. Hane, now that he's a priest, can equip the cross, which is going to be good for his troops. He really doesn't need it, but it doesn't hurt. Definitely want to leave the sword on Aaron. Could probably leave the speed boost on him. And again, keep in mind where people are at for their levels. If someone's about to change class and they won't be able to equip certain items you want them to have, it's a good idea to give it to them before they hit level 10. Such as speed boost, for example. Very useful to give somebody those before they become a knight, for example. When they can't equip it anymore, but if they already have it on, they won't lose it, so they still have that plus 2 movement on top of everything. Same thing with weapons. If they're about to change to another class that can't equip their current weapon, but is very powerful, just leave it on them for as long as you can to get that extra attack. So, we'll go ahead and give the speed boost to Hane, I think. Elwyn doesn't really need them, and again, he can't equip them right now because, again, things that we just talked about. She gets the axe again, and I guess we'll give her the angel wing. Keith is a great candidate for the necklace now that Scott's gone, because the griffins, again, their biggest detriment is defense, so something that will boost their defense as well as their command bonuses, invaluable. Gladiators are going to be very useful once again, like in the last battle, but even more so here, I feel, so. And guards. Guards are going to have their day in the sun. I think they'll be pretty useful too. The best part about guards is when you can get away with using them, they save you so much money compared to monks, which cost 100p a piece. So I'm not going to go all out with them just yet. And probably won't, except for the battles where they're nigh indispensable. We'll get by just fine here though. So as you can see, a very wide map, a lot of water in between us. We're all spread out. Oh, and Soldier, we haven't heard this music track in a while. How much longer until we reach the Great Magician? Just across the river, it looks like. Yeah, someone's coming. Pirates. Bandits. Elwyn doesn't think much of them. And that's with good reason. So, similar to the fight with the Krakens in Warsong, I believe it was Scenario 9 of that game, you don't want to press things. If you're patient, they will come to you. So that's what we're looking to do. Because as you know by now, the name of the game is strategy. So let's use it. By moving everybody in a prime position to pick them off when they arrive. It's our way of saying hi. keep all our commanders surrounded as always. And really just sit back and relax until they make it. Just deciding where we want everybody to go. I think I want to take up all of this real estate here. And this will be one of the rare times that I actually put it on auto, because this is going to take them at least 3 turns, I think, to make it, even with their high movement in the seas. Crocodile Knights, Mermen, just as you remember them from Warsong, except much, much better. I believe I was saying in Scenario 8 that the flying units are my favorite in this game. I take that back. I don't know what I was thinking. I like flyers, but I'm partial to the sea units. Maybe it's because of my love of water in general and all things ocean, but I've always had a soft spot for the mermen and their commanders. And in this game, they're really, really good. Mermen had their uses in Warsong, but they were usually susceptible to everything else in a very, very crippling way. In this game, oh man, they can really hold their own. I mean, they're still not invincible by far, and they still have their weaknesses, but I get far more mileage out of them in this go-around, and you'll see it full well for yourselves if you stick around with me. And I cannot wait. Even on land, they're quite, quite powerful. They still have a relatively low defense rating, but despite that, they can still get the job done. But that's enough of that. We don't have any of them on our side as of yet, so who knows though? This Lester guy seems a little unapproachable, a little stern, a little stubborn, but maybe we can talk or knock some sense into him, one or the other. We'll see how it all pans out. Until then, we're just going to continue to get in position. La 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 la. Where we need to be is right here on dry land. Don't mind me. I do apologize. I can't help it though. Music's so good. How can you not? Open up your heart and sing as the sounds of song fill you. I know, I sure can't help it. Perhaps you're better people than me, though. If so, I salute you. If not, I salute you. Whatever the case may be. I salute you. And we're just twiddling our thumbs. Come on, guys. Let's see what you're capable of, Lester. Impress us. But I warn you, Elwyn is not easily impressed. Here they come. Pirates, I guess, are a lower class than Crocodile Knights. This is a new class. They did that just to spread things out. Similar to the Hawk Knights, how before you didn't have anything before Dragon Knights in the original Langrisser, and now they do have a predecessor. Which I think was a good move. Again, just to give you more classes, more options. So it is turn 3. They're definitely close at hand now. Time to back it up a bit. I just moved a few people forward just to make sure I was going to entice them. I mean, I'm pretty sure they would have moved anyway, but didn't want to take any chances. As always, very mindful of the time. Don't want to make anything longer than it has to be. So Keith, thanks for drawing them out. I don't even think they're going to attack him, because air units make a great counter to sea units. Just as they're getting that extra defense on the water, flyers always get that 25% that we talked about last time. So do I want to take advantage of that fact? Not completely. I just want to see what they do. I'm going to get all up in their face and let them make the first move. See if they have any decisive bones in their bodies. Keep Elwyn back. Wouldn't get too far on the water, I'm pretty sure. And we'll just have to wait one more turn. And then the fireworks should start going off. So we're done here? Yeah. Uh-oh. Music shift. Descendants of Light. She's talking about us. Real monsters. Yeah, it's time for the real fight. Okay, Lester, make up your mind. I don't know what's up with this guy. First you want to fight us, now you want to fight for us? Or rather, you want us to fight for you? By the way, let me take this moment to mention that even though there are no secret items in this fight, there is a bonus item you can receive for keeping the pirates alive. Not their men, not their units. The mermen can fall. But those two pirates and Lester, if they die, well, if Lester dies, I'm pretty sure that's the end of the fight. If his comrades fall, you're going to miss out on another necklace. And there's no such thing as too many necklaces, not at this stage of the game. So it's going to be tough because their AI tends to do questionable things. But I think we can keep them alive if I don't mess around. And Aaron noted that the monster's being manipulated. I don't know how he knows that, but he's been around the block. Don't question it. I trust him. Far more than I trust Lester. And we have werewolves here. If we remember from last time, they shouldn't be too much of a bother. I'd almost be more concerned about the slimes, except for the fact we have guardsmen for this very reason. And they're actually a little easier to kill than they were in the original game. Thankfully. Don't bother attacking Skyla in the water. He's right about that. They are extremely... And I'm not exaggerating. They are exceptionally tough to kill out on the open sea. I wouldn't mess around with it. We will have to draw them on the land. But of course, I knew this going in the whole time. Just, you know... Gotta keep that sense of adventure for you guys if it's your first time. Don't want to spoil everything before we get there. What's the fun in that? But yes, this is why you really want to hold back. Not for Lester and his men, because even if we did rush them, they probably wouldn't have attacked us. Though I have yet to test that theory out. I have no desire to. No need. Elwyn is on the threshold of another level. I think we'll focus on the wolves for right now. They're not a threat, but if I can remove them from the map, it'll be easier to rendezvous with the rest of our people. Keep everybody bunched together if we need to. To better prepare for the arrival of the Skyla. I'm not 100%, maybe that's supposed to be pronounced Scylla or Scylla, but I'm gonna call them Skyla because I don't know. By the way, the Skyla also have magic, including Confusion, which has a much better accuracy rate than it did in Warsong, so it's actually a threat now. There's nothing worse than losing control of your commanders or their troops. Even for one turn, it can make or break a battle. Especially in a battle like this where you're trying to keep NPCs alive. So, level up maybe? Fireball learned. I love that he's getting his spells right off the bat. Level 2, level 3. Let's go. Speaking of magic, this will tear him a new one. Excellent damage. Lizardmen being very, very weak to most magic. The Scylla as well, but to a lesser extent. Scylla. I'm going to be switching around, I can tell. Very close to a level himself is key there. Enjoying his great sword, I can tell. Now actually capable of fighting, as his griffins always were. No damage, I love it. They're gonna need more than a 50% defense boost for him. And level 5, that magical number, thank you. So his tornado's gonna do even more damage next time. Because that's the rule of Langrisser, level 5 and up, your spells become more powerful. I don't know why it's that way, but it is, and I'm glad. Added incentive to get tougher. added incentive to not neglect any of your party members. Let's see. And since she's at 8 health now, she can't outright kill anybody. Which is always a plus. La 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 la. La 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 la. It is going to be a tough battle. So long as we have those Sila on the map, we can't overlook that. I can't remember what other magic they have, but they tend to cast Confuse quite often, which is why we want to do our very best to keep them at 7 or lower. Speaking of which, she is at 7, so she's not going to do anything threatening next round. And this is when you take down the troops. This is the order of Langrisser. Weaken the commander, take down the troops, finish off the leader. Move on to the next group. Wash, rinse, repeat. Yeah, see, monks not as good as the guardsmen against slime. Really just brought them along to do more damage to the units that are not gelatinous, in fact. But for those that are, we have our torches in hand. And, ooh, perfect position. Get that 20% bonus. There you go. This is what I love to see. Who's laughing now? For those who thought they were worthless. Every sun has its season. Every cloud has its drop of rain. Just, ooh, cleaning up shop. This is what it's all about. Okay, they might not finish them off because of the terrain advantage. But they'll, hush my mouth. Never been more happy to be wrong. Cherie. Oh, Cherie. Where to begin? She has 26 defense. It's probably tough enough. I think she'll be okay. Oh, more than okay. There we go. Easy pickems. Oh, I love how this is going. My biggest concern for this battle is always what the pirates are going to do, though. There have been times where they stay close to us, which makes it easier to keep them alive, and then there are times where they just go off and do their own thing. And then they get confused, and then they attack each other, or us, and it doesn't work out well. Yeah. These aren't wolfmen, these are cubs. I feel like I'm committing infanticide here. Surely you guys are holding back tougher stuff than this. Surely. Oh, it's not even a fair fight. I want to attack their leader, but I'm scared of what the gladiators are gonna do to it. So I won't. Curious to see who he's gonna attack, though. And at least Lester is capable of forming proper sentences. Not so sure about his men. Yeah, he just might regret that. Because he's beyond my reach right now. I can't do but so much to help him. Okay. At least he's confident with moving his units. Okay, and now he wants to show off. Okay, didn't blow up in his face, thankfully. He is receiving the same bonuses that they are, so keep that in mind. Oh, he's really spreading his men out. Okay, good formation. Good attack pattern. You guys are doing very well. Keep it up, keep it up. And since Lizardmen and Mermen are pretty much one-to-one in terms of abilities, they're less likely to attack them unless... Yes, they're sitting on 4 health. At that point, it becomes open season. Uh-oh. Our blood, you say? Well, you got them. Oh, no you don't. Oh, but there's probably more where that came from. Yep. No. Why didn't they attack them? It's not gonna get you any easier than that. Eh, AI, what can you do? I'll chalk it up as a fluke. It's seldom that that happens. I'll take it. Oh yeah, I should have known he wouldn't have attacked. And they can't really reach anybody. Okay, maybe this fight won't be as bad as I was expecting, mostly because the pirates are actually somewhat cooperative so far. We'll see how it all pans out though, so. Finally, she got up to level 2. Unicorn Knight is one of those classes with a large experience bar, so it will take a lot to get her to promote. It'll be worth it. Of course it'll be. And we can finish them off, I think. You see, they get that 40% bonus being in the trees, but it was not enough. And it never will be. Not until they get some better defense and attack. Stay tuned for that. There's always a chance that that could happen. Ooh. What happened to your defense line? If they weren't in the mountain, she might have taken them out completely. But that's fine. Gladiators are some of the best ground units to use against slime that are not holy class. And I give you Exhibit A. Now at 2, I'm pretty sure even the horsemen can finish them off. So let's go for it. Yep. Typically, you would not want to send mounted units against slime. They're just not too effective. Unless they're just rocking gross stats, then, you know, they'll just overpower them like anything else. See about finishing them off. So we can start concentrating on the Skyla, which is our real threat. But again, as long as I can keep their health relatively low, they won't be much of a problem either. And that was a commander. Keep in mind that those humble, simple guardsmen did that too. Because I want Aaron to get that experience, he's kind of behind. He's still his second class. We need to fix that as soon as we can. And now he has protection. Very, very useful spell. Ooh, no damage. Excellent. And that was with them getting the defense boost again. Ah, magnificent. I should just attack with Hayne, but... Nah. Still within range of Aaron. So he will bestow his good graces. Bring them back. Definitely want to pull them back. And them. Don't know how you guys survived, but glad for that. Put Hayne there maybe so he'll get that 20%. Yeah. And his men within range. Yes. We're gonna lose them probably now, but it was worth it. Turn undead. Can't use it in this fight. It doesn't work against monsters or demons, just the undead, strictly. So we'll have to save it for a rainy one. Oh, and almost forgot about Keith. So many things he can do. This would be the perfect opportunity to cast Tornado, hit two commanders, but doesn't have the MP just yet. So I'm gonna have to be very strategic in my attacks. Because what I would like to do is make a path to the Skyla. Unfortunately, that one pirate has one of them blocked off almost completely. And only one of my griffins actually is at full health, so that is who I would want to attack her, because she might just one-shot them. They are that powerful. I'm gonna save my game first. Because these fights take too long. I'm actually going to hold off. I'm gonna dare her to attack us. Kinda hoping she attacks those mermen instead. Because we can afford to lose them. I can't even control them, so. That's where we're at with it. And since none of my other troops are at full health over here, I'm just gonna force them to play their hand. And just hope to goodness that none of them cast Confuse. Because then this plan would backfire very quickly. Potentially. And one more down out of its misery. Bring him into view. See how this goes. Pretty good, pretty good. Don't ask me how 21 attack did damage to 27 defense, but stranger things we have yet to see, I'm sure. Now how about you? You're no good in the water. Neither are we, but at least we're stronger. And can't say no to 20%. Pretty good, pretty good. Can't ask for too much more. They had better terrain. Oh, it's rare that you see a commander not do any damage to troops. Magnificent. Equally fantabulous. Okay. That's it for now. What'll it be, enemies? Oh, I keep forgetting about them. They have to have a turn too. Just try not to die, guys, alright? Deal. I wouldn't mind having that necklace. And you know, I kinda have this feeling Lester's gonna join us after the fight, so that'd be nice too. I've kind of been waiting to get a Crocodile Knight on my side. If he does choose to join us, I'm not spoiling anything. If you know me, I'm certainly going to make him a Serpent Knight. It's good to have at least one of those, and that's pretty much what he was destined to be. It's the next best step. I have to admit, though, there is something just inherently cool about somebody who's riding a crocodile. Especially when they learn to tack up. That's another thing I appreciate about this game. As a sequel, it was far more generous in the doling out of magic. So even units that are not known for spellcasting still can learn some abilities, making them more useful, giving them a little bit more utility, a little bit more functioning. More functions, always a plus. This music, though. Serious. And yeah, the Skylas just keep picking off the weakened units. And I kind of hope that trend continues, because if they're attacking, that means they're not casting. And as nasty as that Bolt of Lightning is, trust me, Confuse is much, much worse. It's almost time to help them. Okay, but yeah, that group's okay. The fight's leaving them. This corner, this is who we need to be concerned with. Particularly her, because she still has a lot of troops. Uh-oh, this could be bad. If not for that 50% in the water, he'd be dead. He didn't even manage to do 1 point of damage to her. So now it just got serious. Keith, Tornado, please. You're level 5. Let's see what this can do. Take him down to 7. Take him down to 7. Not quite. Okay, it did the same damage as before, so... yeah, well. Guess it's not an exact science. Maybe it has to do with whether they're inherently weak to certain elements. They don't... I'm pretty sure they're not weak to wind. They're probably weaker to things like fire and definitely thunder. I know thunder tears them up. Which makes sense. Water units, we all know what water conducts. So I would imagine that would smart quite a bit. And fortunately, Hane is on the other side of the map. But at least he'll make life damage easier for that side. And we do have our resident powerhouse, Elwyn, over here. It's just a matter of getting him into the fight. As soon as we clear out this slime, we have a bit of an infestation problem here we need to deal with. And we're pretty close to wrapping that up, so... won't kill him, but it'll hurt. Do slimes feel at all? And if that screams any indication, they do. I'd be lying if I said I felt any remorse for them, though. Let's get them out the way, move him up. And we still got 2 Skyla to deal with. Because she just made it over here. I'm more concerned about this side. Okay. Still got them to deal with too. Don't mind me if I get quiet for a bit, just deciding what to do. I guess we'll start with her. Because the sooner we clear them, the sooner she can go help out somebody else. Somebody who really needs it. Well, might as well. In the interest of expediting the fight, maybe they can finish them off. Oh, they can definitely finish them off. Since they tend to fare worse against the slime, I figured that was a good way to go. And yeah, boss slime really isn't a problem at all. Don't need to worry about them. This is one of the few times where I won't concern myself with damaging the commander. Very high defense, their attack is really nothing to speak of. Face more of a threat from their lackeys. Who again are only boasting a whopping 21 attack. What can you do? Yeah, but I don't want to fight them outside of the command range. That would be fruitless. That would be fruitless as a day in February. If you live in most of the United States. That isn't California or Florida, so on and so forth. I think we got this. Work on that next level, Hane, why don't you? I really don't want to attack that Skyla, not while she's still in the water. I'm pretty confident she's going to take anybody out in one fell swoop. Monks might do pretty well against her, but I'm going to have to take that chance and try to get her out of the water, and just hope again she doesn't cast that confusion spell on the next enemy phase. While they're hurting, this is the time to strike. Just chip away bit by bit, little by little, and do my very best to not let the NPCs steal the experience, because they'll do that. That would be extremely obnoxious. We want to prevent that if we can. After all our hard work to keep them alive, that'd be a terrible way to repay us, and that's exactly what they would do. Thank you, that's one down. Perfect. That should have been good experience for Keith as well. It was. Now, if I can just keep her surrounded so they can't attack her, that would probably be sufficient. But no, her men will recover health on the next round if we don't take them out now, so. In this instance, 6 is better than 9. And if 6 was 9, it really wouldn't matter. But it's not. One little flip makes all the difference, it seems. Life is a fickle thing. But treat it with care. Because it's really all you've got. And it's more than enough. Okay. You can have that one, sure. Just save the generals for me, please. Lester is an exception. I don't mind if he finishes her off. He probably won't. I notice he's playing it very timid now. Go ahead, Big Les. Show us what you can do. You've already talked all that talk. Now walk some walk. And again, you're probably going to join us, so it wouldn't be a waste. Pirate Bob and Pirate Joe, they're not going anywhere. So. And really, would we want them? Probably not. No offense, guys. I'm sure to know you is to love you. But quite frankly, I don't know you. Slimes are just about done for. This should seal the deal. Should, did not. It's alright, we still got more. Now between Elwyn and his remaining troop, I think that's more than... Oh, he's got a few left. What am I saying? Okay, the new victory condition is to wipe out all the enemies, which of course doesn't include the pirates and Lester. And there's not too many left, actually. So what I'm going to do is actually move him forward so that he can contribute to where it counts the most. I think his men will suffice here. Let's give it a go. Excellent. You can't ask for more than that. And since they'll be terrible in the water, because gladiators, if you haven't noticed, have pretty good movement. Squish. As much as I want to, it might be futile. Get rid of them first, since that's more of a sure thing. Keith already almost at another level. Yeah, these Skylas are very good for XP. I would really love to attack, but I'm just too scared it's going to be a waste. I'm just throwing their lives away if I do that. Skylas are just too strong. And at this point, I'm not even going to try to get her on land, so we're just going to have to make do. But again, griffins are our best bet. Keith has Tornado now, Elwyn has Fireball. One way or another, we'll get it done. Just kind of surround her so that they can't swoop in and steal a show from us. My only concern now is this Skyla, who is very much in the water with MP. And on that note, who to hit? Because they're both still getting a bonus. But they're closer. Yeah, see, thunder, more effective than tornado for sure. Aaron can handle this. Not a doubt in my mind. But do I want to attack her? She is at 7, this might not be too terrible. All the same, still not interested. Yeah, we'll just play it a little bit safer for a little bit longer. Get everybody in optimal position, which will take another turn or two. Try to get Sheree to join the fight as quick as we can. She may not be needed though. Still. I think we can swing it. Send you over here. Soften them up real nice. And for the final finishing blow. That wasn't redundant at all, by the way. Good stuff. That just leaves one. Back it up, back it up. This ought to do it. Oh, guys. What do you think? Can one make it? Let's see. Can't argue with that. And look at her movement. Watch out, guys. Our Unicorn Knight is joining the fight. Next time. Stay tuned for Let's Play Languisher 2. There you go, Lester. No need to hold back. You can handle it. Got all these troops. He's still gonna play it safe, though. That's good. They showed a little bit of restraint there. I was hoping for that. See? How about those mermen? Thanks to that 50% bonus. Same as her. Equals the playing field. Oh, yeah. She's still getting 30% on the shore there. It registered as grassland because of who she was attacking, but it still counts. Do not be deceived by some of the things that you see. Nice range, but only enough to hit one. Fortunately, it's the one that we do want to hit. Ooh, almost. Because I would have sent him out. I'm pretty confident he could have handled it. But really, why take the risk when we have griffins? More than enough to get it done, in fact. Ooh, I had to turn away at that. Oh, I almost feel bad for her right now. Can't stand up to that, apparently. And might be able to get those gladiators into view. Yeah, let's do that. See how powerful she is, though? If she's at full health, there's no point. We're descendants of light, fool, we can't be damned. Don't know how true that is, but let's go with it, let's go with it. And not ready to do that. A little bit more shuffling first. Get everybody in tip-top prime condition. Get him out of the way. again, we want to try to get her on dry land. The monks are certainly helping out with that. Just pull everybody, yeah, a little bit further back. Perfect, perfect. We don't want to relinquish any of our advantages. We worked so hard to attain them after all. And even though I want her to get on the plains, I don't want her to get that 20%, so kind of had to do that. Not perfect, but I think we can make it work. And in a moment, the waiting game will begin. That's right, take up all the prime real estate. Let them make their bid. Okay, okay. I'm all right with that. Ah, she couldn't help herself. Four seems to be their favorite number. They're terrible. And I will not be sad to see them go. Just setting it straight. Ow! Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. I was about to hang my head low. All that work for nothing. Because he felt like playing the fool. He should have just retreated. So we have to make our move, and we have to make it count. And we have to make it now. Ooh, look at her fighting back. No punk, no slouch. And he can't quite make it. But they can. Get them a little bit closer, just in case they're needed. And this might end up going to Keith then. Or Lester if he actually decides to attack next time. Yeah, I'm actually gonna hold off. Don't mind if she recovers a little bit of health because we've got everybody where they need to be. Now that Elwyn's arrived, it's pretty much over for her. Need to be more concerned with these two, honestly. And anybody can dispatch the lizards, not worried about them. We're just gonna try it. I figured with their high attack, they would manage at least a couple of points, and thankfully they did. Definitely wanna heal up Cherie before we send her forward. And, oh, she can actually reach, really? Even in the water. Do I wanna do that though? I might want to. I have to plan this really carefully. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm gonna let Cherie step in and clean this up. We'll let Aaron's men weaken them. Oh, and they're getting 25%. They might, yeah, they actually finished them off. Okay, even better. I was thinking I could let Cherie's men clean it up, but it wasn't necessary. And they can't move as far as I would like, but that's okay. They will next round. Don't really want to attack that one. I guess I'm going to hold off a little longer. I just don't want those mermen to swoop in and steal it. But I'm pretty confident they won't. We'll see if I'm wrong, though. Good, they're holding back. And Lester's getting back. Apparently he doesn't want any part of this. Too bad, he could have really did some damage there. Made it easier for us. Oh, speaking of making it easier, Luffy decided to come ashore. Thanks, Skyla. I take back all the bad things I said about you. Even if they were true. And let's see. Can't use Tornado. So? Think I'm gonna have to use Fireball instead. Or I could use Sleep. Or I could Treat. Hopefully I don't regret this. Obviously not gonna attack with them now. Skyla at full health on the water is a pretty tall order for anybody, even griffins. So we'll just hold off a little longer. We still have them to deal with, so more than enough to keep us occupied. Probably should have taken her out when I had the chance. Still can, it's just gonna take a little bit more effort now. Wow, that was amazing. That one troop did 2 points of damage, and she's on the water. You will not see that every day. So let's try to take advantage. Okay. Sheree, we need you. Your men have given me the confidence to proceed with this, and you did not let me down. Guan, get out of here. We've had enough of you, you filthy animal. Aaron, Hayne, what do you guys say? This is your best chance. And we're gonna soften up with a spell just to play it safe. Let's do it. Yeah, she still has a terrifying attack, though. She strikes first, it strikes fast, and it does a lot of damage. Nevertheless, we're getting close. The conclusion to this battle is almost within sight. And look at Aaron go. The elder hero himself. Way to go. Alright, so that's one half of the map settled and done. It's time to put the final nail in it. Thanks for all the help, Lester. Couldn't have done without you. Just want you to know that. And she just had her last hurrah. Because her day in the sun is done. Let's make it official. Starting off with a tornado? Because 10 is not a good look for her. And she might have good magic resistance, so I think it's better to do damage than attempt sleep. She may be one of the few enemies who will be completely immune to it. Not the time to test it out. Come on, guys. Is it gonna take another turn, maybe? Maybe not. She is resilient. So are they, though. Griffins? Or horses? Not griffins. Let's try horses. Splendid. We did it. We're trying to cross the river. Over yonder. Keep going into that old-timey talk. Like, I don't know nothing about that. I want to get acquainted with her. It's not like that. We're not interested in that way. Ah, Lester. Always suspecting the worst. That's the impression I get from him. Treasure, you say? Nobody knows treasure like a pirate. That's that necklace we wanted. And a level up for Elwyn. Icing on top of the cake. She got charm. Thus concludes the battle at Raw River. Please join me next time where we get introduced to a huge VIP of the Lancaster series. And that's all I'm going to say. Until then, hope you're having and continue to have a wonderful day with your loved ones. Take care of yourselves, and hopefully, see you soon.